I'm going to try to explain suffering and beauty in terms of a story of art, which is basically how I explain everything. But every person is gifted suffering like a pile of bricks. Now, some people they have 20 bricks, other people may just have two or three. And we're not inclined to want to carry any more than what we had to start off with. But nonetheless, as we experience life, we will receive more and more suffering that stacks upon the pile we already have. And at some point, it'll become too much for us, and we'll drop the bricks and fall to our knees. And when this happens, this moment of reckoning or grief, you may cry physical tears or not, but the bricks crush into a dust. And through the acknowledgement of suffering, the tears, you can turn it into a clay and build a beautiful sculpture and carry it with you proudly. And then as life goes on, you'll get more and more bricks and you'll fall again and you'll grieve over what it is to suffer. And then you'll have more and more clay and you can just keep building more and more beautiful things every time you fall. But most people don't want more weight. They don't see the potential of what suffering can be made into. And you'll get to a point where you have more clay than your body. And soon you've created an effigy of humanity. And it's larger than you, and you realize how small you are. And you're effectively worshiping the human condition. You finally see the beauty within suffering. And from there, when you can't possibly carry any more, all you want to do is further refine it and make it more beautiful. At least that's my take on beauty and suffering.